Hello my dear friends, welcome to Java programming playlist. In this video we are going to see method overloading in Java. In the previous video we have seen what is method and how can we call the method. In this video we are going to see a concept called method overloading. Let us introduce what is method overloading. In Java, it is possible for a class to contain two or more methods with the same name. So, my dear friends, in Java, we can have two or more methods with the same name. So, name of more than one method can be same, but with a different parameters. The number of parameters are different, or the data types of the parameters are different. Such methods are called overloaded methods. Method overloading is used to increase the readability of the program. So if you want to have a method which can do multiple things, then we can use method overloading. So what is the syntax? So here there is this method name foo which is overloaded here. So here you can see that there is this method name foo with no arguments and return type void. Then you have this again same method with the name foo, return type is void, but it is having one argument. Then we can have again the another method which is again named foo, which having return type as integer, but there are two arguments here. Instead of this integer argument, we can have another foo which can have a float as an argument or double as an argument. Ways to perform method overloading. First is by changing the data type of the arguments of methods and its return type. So just I have said that, let's say if there is this method foo, then we can have another method foo which can have a float as an argument, or we can have integer return type and float as an argument, or integer return type and integer as an argument. Second way is by changing the number of arguments accepted by this method. So here I can have another foo defined with integer return type and only one argument, that is the integer as an argument. But if I am doing that, then I cannot have void foo integer a. That means we cannot have method overloaded with just change in the return type. Okay, we have to have change in the arguments compulsorily, or we can do some combination of data type change or number of arguments change. Changing the return type of the method. In the example on the next slide, class name calculate is created. In the calculate class, methods with the same name, that is multiply, is defined. So in that class you will find that there is a method multiply and it is all overloaded. That means you will find different methods with the same name multiply. These methods are overloaded because they have the same name but have different combinations of return type and argument. So here we are changing the arguments that are passed. So there is this method multiply. So we are return two methods with the same name. In the first method, the return type is integer, while in the another, the return type is double. So let us look at the sample code. So here there are two methods, multiply and multiply. Here it is taking two arguments, here also it is taking two arguments, but the difference is the two arguments are of type integer here, and here the two arguments of type double. Either return type is integer and here the return type is double. So now let us call this method and let us see what will happen. So there is this object created of the class calculate. obj.multiply 5,4. So now the question rises, this multiply will call this multiply first one or the second one. So here it will check for the data type of the argument. So the data type of these two arguments 5 and 4 are integers. So it will match to the first multiply and it will call this, and result will be obtained from this. The second multiply here will have 5.1 and 4.2. So this 5.1 is a double value and 4.2 is also a double value. So it will call this second method multiply with the double argument. And so printing this multiply method returns integer. So first case we are expecting it returns an integer and the value will be stored in 20. And the second is returning a double. So let us see the output of this program. Multiply method returns integer and 20. So 5 into 4. So it is 20 here. And this 5.1 into 4.2. Here it will be 5.1 into 4.2. So that is actually 21.42. But because of the precision, it is giving us 21.41999998. Let us look at the second type of calling the method or method overloading, that is by changing the number of arguments passed. So again we are defining two methods with the same name, multiply. The return type of both the methods are integer, it is the same, but the difference here is that the first method accepts two arguments and the another method, the second method, accepts three arguments. Let us look at the code of that. So here is this class calculate, multiply, multiply. There are two methods with the same name, same return type, integer, integer. But the first method here, it is taking two arguments A and B, and here it is taking three arguments A, B and C. Let us call this and see what happens. So again, we have to create an object to call the method. So obj is the object, obj.multiply 5, 4. So what is expected? There are two arguments, so it should call this first method, and here it is multiply 5, 4, 3. So there are three arguments, so it should call this second method. So in the first method it is multiplying A and B and the result is returned, and in the second method it is A, B and C, the multiplication, and the result is returned. So we are printing this value C and D here. Let us see what is the output. So here it is 5 into 4, which is 20. So first it is printing 20 here, the C value, and 5 into 4 into 3. So 20 into 3 is 60. So this D value is 60, it is printing 60. So the mapping is done. The first method call, which is having two arguments, is calling the method with two parameters, and the value of three arguments is calling the method with three parameters. This is an important note to make it, my dear friends. Method overloading cannot be performed just by changing the return type of methods. Okay, so if you have two methods and the only difference is the return type, such method overloading is not permitted in Java. That we have to take care while writing the method overloading program. I hope this is very much clear, my dear friends. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for more videos on Java programming.